and see me okay? I'll just put this down a little bit more. Okay, so find a comfortable seat on your yoga mat. And you can take a moment, like always, if you want to get a little bit of stretching in right here in the beginning, just feeling into your body. I love in the morning, especially, just to kind of move, see how my body feels after I wake up. Sometimes we sleep a little bit funky. You can feel into those tight spaces. Just see what's going on inside. And then when you are ready, no rush, just settle into stillness. So sitting up nice and tall. Yay, and Christine. Sit up nice and tall with length in your spine, length in the back of your neck. And then place your hands intentionally. So wherever you want them, on your lap is fine, to your heart, one hand to heart space, one hand to belly. So up to you. And then just take a moment. Close your eyes. Start to notice your breath. Start to notice physical sensations and also energetic sensations that might be present, emotions that might be there. So just noticing, feeling, and observing. And let's start our practice, just drop into our practice with three great big deep breaths. So next time you inhale, fill up as big as you can and hold at the very, very top. And when you think you're full, see if you can even sip in just a little bit more. Exhale, big open mouth sigh, let it go. Do that two more times. So inhale, fill up. Hold in fullness. Take a moment to pause at the top and just feel this prana, this life force energy inside of you. And when you're ready, a big sigh, release, let it go. Do that one more time. So biggest inhale you've taken all morning. Wake your body up from the inside, hold in fullness, keep holding, and as you hold, soften around the breath, soften your outer shell, your outer body. And then when you're ready, that huge audible exhale out your mouth. Seal your lips gently now and start to cultivate ujjayi breath, so in and out through your nose with a gentle constriction in the back of your throat. So each inhalation moves all the way down the length of your torso, the length of your spine. You feel your low belly and your low back inflate as you breathe in. You feel really your entire upper body just expand with your breath. And then each exhalation, see if you can exhale all the way to emptiness. Find the very bottom of your exhale. And then draw your belly button back and up towards your spine. Find what we call Uddiyana Bandha, so that connection to center, your core lock. And if you'd like to stay for a little longer in your seated meditation this morning, feel free. When you are ready to add some movement, take your breath with you. And if you want to start movement from your seat, feel free. So it might be nice to kind of circle your torso around, maybe bring your fingertips behind you, lift your heart up. So anything that calls to you from your seat, but eventually we will find our way onto hands and knees. So absolutely no rush, but eventually tabletop. And then same thing, just intuitive, mindful movement. And I personally prefer to close my eyes so I can get out of my head a little bit more easily. So without thinking so much about how you look, if you're doing it right, if you look weird, let go of all of that and just feel what feels good. Are there different ways you can move through your spine and your shoulders that you didn't even realize? Is there more space in your hips if you really explore it? Maybe you can find a little more mobility, not just through your upper and your lower back, but start to feel into your mid back a little bit more. So for some reason, our mid backs kind of get lost in translation. When we move, most of the movement in our spine comes from our lower and our upper back. So start to bring more mobility into the center of your spine. Start to feel into that. And I'm gonna say, give this about 3 to 5 more rounds. So if it's feeling really good, then stay a little longer. If you're about ready to move on, downward facing dog is where we will eventually end up. So find your way there as you're ready. And then once you're back in your down dog, so no hurry, we're just gonna do the same thing. Explore movement. Pedal out your heels. Shake your head, yes or no. Maybe move, sway from side to side. So you can move your hips to one side, bend one knee, straighten the opposite leg. So as creative as you want to get in your downward facing dog is perfectly welcome. For this first down dog, just let go of alignment a little bit. And feel more just into your body. So if you want to round your spine for a moment, maybe lift up to your tiptoes, straighten out your legs, push the ground away. Might feel really good. If you want to bend your knees a ton and really lift your hips up high. So lots of ways to explore. Get curious. Be intuitive, so go inward, listen to your body, and then make sure, now that we've started moving, your breath is still there, it's still big and powerful. Good job, you guys. Take just a couple more breaths in your downward facing dog. And then as you're ready, again, no rush, but we'll walk our hands back to our feet, coming into a forward fold at the back of our yoga mat. So get there in your next breath or two. Eventually, you'll end up with your feet about hips width distance apart. You can widen them a little bit more if you'd like. Make sure all 10 toes face forward, and then grab opposite elbows. Take a nice, easy ragdoll pose. Let your upper body perhaps sway from side to side, or maybe bob a little bit up and down. Notice your weight and make sure it's slightly forward in your feet so you're not rocking back into your heels and locking out your knees. Weight is more forward, little or big bend in your knees, and really think of lifting your sit bones, your butt, up towards the sky. So like I always say, imagine you've got a rope attached to your belly button that's pulling up towards the ceiling, so you want to feel that lift coming from your center. Breathe into your back body. Breathe down the length of your spine and then down the length of the backs of your legs. Take just a couple more rounds here. And then next time you breathe in, halfway lift. So spinal extension, take a moment and get all the rounding out of your back. Really stick your butt out behind you, press back through the tops of your thighs. Exhale, let it go, fold. Do that once more, inhale, halfway lift. So crown of your head reaches forward, tops of thighs press back, sit bones broaden. Exhale, fold. And your choice, either roll or reverse swan dive all the way up to stand. As you inhale, stretch your arms to the sky. And exhale, hands to your heart center, Anjali Mudra. Flow with your breath. Inhale, high mountain. Exhale, heart leads, slow swan dive down. So lengthen your spine for as long as you can, then let it go and fold. Halfway lift, Ardha Uttanasana. Breathe in. And exhale, bow, fold in. Press into your feet. This time, everybody, reverse swan dive. So lead with your heart. Feel your back muscles hugging around your spine. Inhale, arms to the sky. Exhale, hands to heart center. All right, let's add just a little back bend this time. So inhale, high mountain. And as you exhale, cactus your arms, lift and open through your heart. Keep a little tone in your belly. Inhale, arms re-extend. And then exhale, slow dive. Follow your breath. Let it guide you all the way down. With your big inhalation, spinal extension. So really use your breath to lengthen. Think of creating space in between each little vertebra in your spine. Exhale, let it go, fold. This time we're gonna crawl our hands forward to the top of our mat until you find yourself in a plank position. So wrists under shoulders, spread your fingers wide, think of pushing the ground away, and then hips level with your shoulders, draw your belly button in and up. Take an inhale here, and as you exhale, just lift your hips and press them back, down dog. Maybe you bend your knees a lot. So lengthen through your spine. Inhale, come forward to your high plank. See if you can come way forward so you are on your tippy toes. And then exhale, one more time, take it back, down dog. This time we're going to add a push-up. Inhale, come forward, high plank. You're on your tippy toes or bring your knees down. Exhale, halfway down. Bend your elbows, keep your belly strong. Inhale, press back up. Exhale, down dog. Stretch it out. One more time like that. Inhale, come forward. Exhale, lower halfway. Keep your shoulders strong. Don't let them roll forward. Inhale, press up. And exhale, press back, down dog. This time, we'll come forward to our high plank. Breathe in. And exhale as slow as you can all the way to your belly. Inhale, Spider-Man Cobra, my favorite. So hands out nice and wide. Lift to your fingertips, elbows face the sky, lift your chest up. Take an inhale here, and as you exhale, twist to one side. I'll let you choose which way you want to go. Inhale, come back through center. And exhale, twist to the other side. Go one more time in each direction with your own breath at your own pace. If you want to try widening your hands even more, maybe just see how that feels. And then eventually, an inhale will bring you back to center. As you exhale, release and let it go. Hands frame your mid ribs. You can move through a reverse push-up, through tabletop, through child's pose. Just mindfully find your way back to downward facing dog. This time in your down dog, focus more on your alignment. So spread your fingers really wide, press down and grip the ground with the pads of your fingertips. Broaden through your shoulders, so outer rotation in your shoulders. But as you rotate your shoulders out, see if you can keep rotating your forearms in. So really press down through your thumbs and your index finger. Lift from your center. Breathe big, deep breaths. You can have a big or a little bend in your knees. If it feels okay to press your heels to the ground and you can still keep the length in your spine, go for it. Let's take one more big inhalation. Imagine that invisible rope pulling up on your belly button. Exhale, gaze forward this time. Step, tiptoe, or hop forward, fold. Once you've arrived, halfway lift, breathe in. And exhale, release, let it go. Root through your feet. Let's take it all the way up to stand. Inhale, arms stretch, reach. And exhale, hands to heart. All right, my friends, we're gonna move into a little bit of balance. So inhale, take your arms to the sky. Right foot is going to stay rooted. Float your left knee up, standing step. So find your balance here first. Focus your gaze on something in front of you that is not moving. Hug in with your inner thighs. Tone your low abdominals. We'll move into airplane pose. So bring your left heel to your left butt cheek. So just kind of swing your leg back. Start to hinge at your hips. Reach your arms back. And as you reach back, extend through your left leg. Think of a smiley face shape from the top of your head back to your toes. Hips stay square. Back muscles hug around your spine. Take one more great big huge breath, your fullest expression. And then end of your exhale, low lunge. So step your left toes to the back of your mat and bring your hands to the ground, framing your front foot. Take a moment to bend and straighten your front leg a few times. So just at your own pace, straighten and bend your front leg. If you have blocks at home and you want to use them underneath your hands, or even books, go for it. Good job. One more time, bend and straighten. And then back to a regular lunge position. So your right knee is directly over your ankle. Back leg is strong. You're high on the ball of your back foot. Keep your left hand on the ground. Reach your right arm to the sky. Revolve lunge. So squeeze through your inner thighs. Twist from your center. Back leg stays strong and powerful, as well as your back foot. Imagine you want to pull your right hip towards the back of your mat, but then at the same time, your right knee and shin hug towards your left armpit. Take two more rounds. Twist from your center, wringing out. Let go of anything that you no longer need. So any stuck energy that's there, breathe it out. Take one more round. End of your exhale. Unwind. Walk both of your hands over to the left side of your mat. Straighten out your legs and parallel your feet. So you're in a wide-legged forward fold. Inhale to a halfway lift. Exhale, let it go. Now listen, root through your feet, reverse swan dive all the way up to stand. Inhale, take your arms to the sky. Good, and then as you exhale, warrior two. So pivot your right toes to face forward, bend your right knee, and reach your right arm forward, left arm back. If you want to take a moment to kind of adjust through your legs, maybe gaze down, look at your feet, you're welcome to. So right toes face directly forward, left toes face directly to the left. Settle in. Wrap your right butt cheek underneath your body and try to keep a nice neutral pelvis. So a lot of times people kind of press their left hip forward. Try to keep your pelvis nice and neutral while allowing your hips to open. And then little tone through your low, deep abdominals. Next time you breathe in, reverse your warrior. So rotate your front palm up, reach up. Reach back, lengthen your right side. So breathe down your right side. Maybe bend just a little bit deeper into your front knee. Keep pressing into the inner and outer edge of your back foot. If there's a variation you like and you want to take, go for it. Take about two more rounds. Breathe into the space between your right ribs. Breathe into your right waistline. One more great big inhale, everybody. Really stretch and reach. And then exhale, come back to your warrior two. Straighten out your front leg. If you want to shorten your stance by just a little bit, an inch or so, you can. So we're setting up for triangle, Trikonasana. Think of reaching your right fingertips forward and at the same time, let your left hip kind of pull back like there's a rope attached to the outside of your hip. It's pulling back. So right fingertips forward, left hip back, and then just tip it over. Right hand towards the ground, left arm towards the sky. Keep everything open. Hips are open, shoulders are open, chest is open, low abdominals are toned, and then imagine you want to rotate your heart to look up at the sky. You can stay where you're at, or reach your left arm forward, so left side body nice and long. stay pretty light on your right hand. So it's there for support, but your weight is not going down into your right hand. It's not supporting you completely. Take about two more breaths in your pose. And then from here, you guys, we're gonna move into half moon. So everybody, for your transition, bring your left hand to your hip. Gaze forward out in front of your right toes. Bend your right knee and reach forward. You can kind of let your back leg slide or back foot slide along the ground and then float your back foot up. Half moon pose, Ardha Chandrasana. And eventually left arm to the sky. If you feel like you want to take the bind, you're more than welcome to if that's in your practice. Think of breathing and lengthening in every direction. Back leg strong and powerful, like you're trying to stomp it onto an invisible wall behind you. Make sure you have some engagement still in your belly. So if you were to look back at your left foot, and I know it's hard, you should be able to see your left toes. You don't want your left foot too far back behind you that you can't just look back at your foot. Take one more great, big, huge breath. And then end of your exhalation, forward fold. So fingertips to the ground, left foot to the top of your mat, nice and easy. And you can give your right leg a gentle shake out. Both feet on the ground, halfway lift, spinal extension. Now from here, so feet about hips width distance apart if they're not already. Bring your left fingertips to the ground, bend your left knee a lot, and then right arm to the sky for a little twist. Stay rooted through the inner edge of your right foot, and imagine you're trying to pull your right hip towards the back of your mat. Breathe down the length of your right leg. So your right leg is as straight as possible, left knee is bent, twist from your center. Maybe gaze up at your right fingertips, or even wrap your right arm behind your back. Take two more rounds. Nice job. Very end of your second exhale. Unwind. Let's bring our big toes to touch now. Little gap in between your heels. Tuck and curl. Tiny little potato bug ball. So take a moment here. Think of this as your reset. Breathe into your back body all the way down into your low back. Empty out completely with each exhale. If you want to wrap your arms around the fronts of your shins, give yourself a big squeeze, go for it. Take one more round. Next, inhale, halfway lift. So spinal extension, realign. Exhale, listen, plant your hands, step back to plank position. From your plank pose, we've got side plank, right hand is our base. So roll onto the baby toe edge of your right foot, left arm to the sky, lift your hips super high, press the ground away with your right hand, option to reach your left arm forward, option to float your left leg up. If you want to modify, you guys know you always can, feel free to bring your left knee down. So your fullest expression here, take about two more deep breaths. And then listen, we're going to slowly transition to forearm side plank with our left forearm on the ground. So bring your left forearm down, roll onto the baby toe edge of your left foot, right arm to the sky, lift your hips. Stay here or right arm reaches forward, right leg floats up. So use those left side abdominals, your oblique muscles. Really press down through the belly of your forearm so you're not sinking into your left shoulder. Breathe, big deep breaths. Take two more. See if you can lift your hips a little bit higher. End of your two breaths. Now we'll go into a full forearm plank pose. So both forearms down, elbows underneath your shoulders, hips level with your shoulders. Push the ground away with the belly of your forearms. Draw navel to spine. Breathe into your back body. Take just about two more breaths in your forearm plank.
And then after those two breaths, move into a dolphin pose. So slowly crawl your toes forward closer to your elbows. Lift your hips high. Try not to let your elbows drift apart, so keep hugging them in. Lift from your center. You can absolutely just stay here. I shouldn't even say just. You can absolutely stay here, or you're welcome to take your right leg to the sky or even play with a few little forearm stand hops. Three more rounds wherever you've chosen to go. Keep lifting from your center. Soften your face. Press down through the belly of your forearms. Hug in with your elbows and your upper arms. One last inhale. If you want to, big exhale out your mouth. Ha. Bring your knees down. Sit back, either child's pose, embryo pose, or seated meditation, hero's pose. So take a moment and try as best you can to just let everything kind of soften, melt, relax. Soften your face, your shoulders. Slow down your breath. Big, expansive, spacious inhales, long, steady exhales, all the way to empty. Notice, feel, and observe. In your next couple of breaths, we will meet back in Downward Facing Dog. All right. From your down dog, inhale, take your right leg to the sky, and then open up your right hip. So bend your right knee, squeeze your outer right butt cheek, right knee reaches out to the right and then up. Try not to sink into your left wrist, your left shoulder, or your left hip. So the left side of your body really should not move much at all when you open your hip. Take one more big inhale, and you're welcome to stay here if you want to. Exhale, right knee to your left elbow. So as close as you can come, hips level with your shoulders. Draw your belly button in and up. Inhale, three-legged dog, right leg extends back. Exhale, right to right. So get as high as you can on your right arm. If you want to add a push-up, go for it. Inhale, three-legged dog. And then exhale, step your right foot to the top of your yoga mat. Pyramid pose. So step your back foot forward about a foot or so. I like my feet on two train tracks with all 10 toes facing forward. Some people prefer a balance beam. I think that's more traditional with your back foot at a slight angle. So whatever feels best in your body and specifically your hips. Both feet should be flat on the ground. Inhale to a halfway lift. So lengthen your spine. Exhale, fold. Now listen, root into both feet, reverse swan dive to stand. So all the way up, inhale, stretch your arms up. Exhale, little baby back bend, cactus your arms, lift your heart. Keep your low abdominals toned and strong. Inhale, arms to the sky. And then exhale, think of an airplane pose or a chair plane. So arms reach back. As you hinge at your hips, bring your spine pretty much parallel to the ground, but keep that little baby cobra in your chest. Really think of pulling your right butt cheek back, moving your left hip forward, so working your hips more towards square. Take one more big inhale here. Keep leading with your heart, so keep your hands reaching back for now. Reach your heart down like you're trying to reach past your front knee. And then when you've gone as far as you can go, my leg starts to shake a little bit. You can bring your fingertips to the ground. Just be in your pyramid pose. Take about 4 or 5 deep breaths here. Keep working your right sit bone back and up. left hip moves forward and down. If it's helpful, you can always bring one hand to your low back, to your sacrum, and feel, do your hips feel level? Is one higher than the other? How can you adjust so that you're getting your optimal alignment and this pose is working as best it can for your body? Each time you exhale, you guys, draw your belly button in and up and see if you can fold just a little bit further from the inside. So really working the pose with each breath. Relax your neck, soften your face. Take one more great big huge inhale. One last exhale, dive as deep as you can. End of your exhale, crawl your fingertips forward so you can bend into your front knee for a moment, and then back leg floats up for standing splits. From standing splits, listen carefully. Take a great big inhale, see if you can lift your left leg a little higher, and then exhale, left knee to your nose. Now stay here with your left leg lifted. Can you bring your hands up to your heart center? So really press down into your right foot. Now, can you stay balanced on your right foot? Come all the way up, woo, to standing staff pose. So right back where we began, that whole entire sequence, left knee lifts, arms reach up. You can stay here or extend your left leg forward. Just make sure you don't lean back. Hold for five, keep breathing. Four, stand taller, two, lift your left leg a little higher, and one, let it go. Shake it out. Feels good. So shake, 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 just a little bit more. Lots of you have probably heard me say this, but animals, you see animals shake. So they shake to get rid of trauma. That's what we're doing. We're shaking, we're resetting, we're getting rid of any trauma that I just caused you. And then find your way back to your mountain pose. Arms by your sides, palms open. So just standing tall, standing well, standing with awareness. Find stillness, close your eyes. Feel from the inside. Feel your alignment, your posture from the inside. Feel your breath, that prana moving through you. Stay as you are, but breathe in as big as you can. Inhale, hold in fullness. Sip in a little bit more, stand even taller, grow taller, and exhale, big open mouth sigh. Let it go. Come back to Ujjayi breath, arms to the sky. Now root into your left foot, float your right knee up, find your balance on your left foot. So hug in with your inner thighs, flex your toes, tone your belly. We'll move into our airplane pose slowly. So start by just swinging your right leg back, so heel towards your butt, and then hinge at your hips. Little bend in your standing leg, arms swing back, and start to extend your right leg. So like you're pushing back through your right foot. Keep that little lift in your chest like you're doing a baby cobra. Back muscles hug your spine. Smiley face shape from the crown of your head back to your toes. Two more rounds, your fullest expression. Lengthen through the back of your neck. Use the strength in your inner thighs to lift your back heel level with your front shoulders. One more inhale. Exhale, low lunge, softly if possible. So right toes to the back of your mat, hands to the ground. And then just at your own time and pace, straighten and bend your front knee a few times. And you can plug in your breath in whatever way makes most sense to you. Just make sure it's there, it's intentional. Bend and straighten. If there's some other movement that your legs are calling for, like opening your left hip or something like that, please always feel free. This is your practice.
Make it feel good for you. Make it work for you. One more time. Straighten and bend. And then low lunge position. So left knee right over your ankle. High on the ball of your back foot. Right hand stays on the ground. Left arm to the sky. Revolve lunge. So twist from your center. Nice, you guys. Squeeze your inner thighs. Keep your back legs strong. See if you can imagine pulling your left hip towards the back of your mat. At the same time, left knee and shin hug towards your armpit. You guys look so good. Nice work. Take two more breaths. Breathe down into your belly. And as you exhale, work your twist from the inside. Ring out. Detox. So let go of anything you no longer want. Any stuck energy. End of your next exhale. Release and let it go. Bring your hands all the way over to the right side of your mat. Parallel your feet. Straighten your legs. So wide-legged fold for just a moment. Inhale, halfway lift. Exhale, fold, and then press into your feet, lead with your heart, rise all the way up. Inhale, arms to the sky. Exhale, warrior two. So left toes, pivot forward, bend your left knee, reach your arms forward and back, settle in, Virabhadrasana two. Wrap your left butt cheek underneath your body and stay rooted through your back foot firmly. Remember, make sure your right hip isn't bulging forward. So neutral pelvis, allow your hips to open, soften your shoulders, breathe. Next inhalation, reverse your warrior. So front palm rotates up, reach up, find length, reach back. Maybe bend a little deeper into your front knee and then feel your breath traveling through your left side body. The space in between your left ribs, your left waistline. Keep your hips open. Keep your pelvis neutral. Keep your belly toned. Couple more rounds. And then next time you inhale, come back up, warrior two. Straighten out your front leg. Perhaps shorten your stance by just an inch or two, not a lot. Triangle posture. So left fingertips reach forward, right hip pulls back. So it's like you're being pulled in two opposite directions. And then eventually, just tip it over. Like I'm a little teapot. So left hand towards the ground, right arm towards the sky. Chest is still open, heart open, shoulders open, hips open. Little tone in your belly. So it shouldn't feel like you're doing a back bend here, you guys. It should feel like you've got a nice neutral spine as much as possible. Just a little bit of weight in your left hand. So if you were to lift your left hand, you should still be able to hold the pose just fine. Stay where you're at, or right arm extends forward. So lengthen from right fingertips all the way back to your right hip. About two more rounds in your triangle. And you know what's coming, half moon. So to make the transition, right hand to your hip, gaze forward out in front of your left toes and start to reach. So bend into your front knee. You can slide your back foot along the ground for a moment and then pick it up. Strong through your back leg, press with your back foot. When you feel like you've got it, right arm to the sky. And if you want to, you can always add your bind, totally up to you. Wherever you're at, your fullest expression, feel into it. Make sure you are still engaged through your low, deep abdominals. So again, it doesn't feel like you're doing a back bend. It shouldn't feel like that unless you're in the bind. Otherwise, straight and strong. If you looked back, you should be able to see your right toes. They're not behind you. Breathe. Couple more rounds, fullest expression. Think of breathing length and space in all directions. If you want to get crazy, see if you can gaze up. Whee! That throws me so off balance. One more inhale.
And exhale, forward fold. So fingertips to the ground, right foot to the top of your mat. You can give your left leg a nice little shake out. And then both feet on the ground, hips width distance apart. Inhale, halfway lift. Now pause here. Bend your right knee. Right fingertips come down underneath your chest. Left arm to the sky. Twist. Stay rooted through the inner edge of your left foot. Try to pull your left hip back as you work your left leg maybe a little bit straighter. Right knee can bend a lot. Left arm might wrap behind you, just an option. Big breaths down into your belly. Use your exhales to twist, twist, twist. Last round, big, huge, full body breath. End of your exhale, unwind. Bring your big toes to touch, little gap in between your heels. Tuck and curl, tiny little potato bug ball. So again, we're using this as a reset. Breathe into your back body. Exhale all the way to empty. Find your center at the end of each exhale. If you want to give your legs a squeeze, go ahead, wrap your arms around the fronts of your shins, squeeze one last breath. Next inhalation, back to your halfway lift position. Exhale, plant your hands, step back to plank. Now we've got Vashisthasana, side plank on our left hand. So roll onto the baby toe edge of your left foot, take your right arm to the sky. Hips super high. If you want to modify, you know you can, always. You can bring your left knee down, no big deal. Option to reach your right arm forward. Option to float your right leg up. As you float your right leg up, see if you can lift your hips higher. Soften your face, two more rounds. Push the ground away, lift through your left side obliques. End of your next exhale, slowly with control, forearm side plank. So right forearm comes down. Roll to the baby toe edge of your right foot. Left arm to the sky. Reach up. This one to modify, I think the easiest way is just left foot out in front of you so you can kind of step onto your left foot. So option to go there or option to reach your left arm forward. Maybe float your left leg up. Your variation. Really press down through the belly of your right forearm. Couple more breaths. Soften your face, breathe slow and deep. Good work. Slowly with control, full forearm plank pose. So both forearms to the ground. Draw navel to spine, back of your neck is long. Breathe into your back body. Keep pushing the ground away. Keep softening through your face. So just remind yourself, soften around it. Soften around it. Take one more inhale. With your exhale, crawl your toes towards your elbows and lift your hips as high as you can. So imagine that rope, it's pulling up on your belly button. Keep hugging your elbows in. Don't let them drift apart. Try to press your chest back as you lift your hips higher. If you want to take your left leg to the sky or play with some hops, you're welcome to. About three more rounds. Strong shoulders, strong belly. Lengthen through your side bodies. Soften through your face. Press the earth away. One last inhale. If you want to, exhale out your mouth. Ha. Knees down. Your choice, child's, embryo, or hero's pose. So take a moment. Slow down your breath. Feel energy moving through your body. So it's energy that is always there. It's always inside of you. It's just not always easy to notice. Or easy to feel.
Good job, my friends. Two or three more rounds here. So fire up your ujjayi breath. Bring it back. And then when you're ready, downward facing dog. From your down dog, inhale, left leg to the sky. Without moving much at all through your right side, so pay attention to that. Open up your left hip, bend your knee, left knee reaches out to the left, then up towards the sky. So I know it's so much easier to just kind of collapse into your right side. Try to keep your right leg or your right side nice and strong in alignment. That's probably the most common misalignment in this posture. Just sinking into your right side. It's so much easier, I know. Take one more big inhale. If you want to stay here, you can. Otherwise, exhale, left knee to your right elbow. So use your obliques, twist, get as close as possible. Inhale, three-legged dog. Exhale, left to left, as high as you can get on your left arm. Draw navel to spine, add the push-up if you want. Inhale, three-legged dog. Exhale, step your left foot all the way up. So knee to nose and then left foot steps through. Pyramid stance. So step your back foot forward a foot or so. This just kind of depends on how long your legs are. And either both feet on two train tracks with all 10 toes facing forward or feet on a balance beam with a little angle in your back foot. Inhale to a halfway lift position. So lengthen your spine, pull your left butt cheek back. Exhale, fold, and then press into your feet, lead with your heart, rise all the way up to stand. Inhale, stretch your arms to the sky. Exhale, little baby back bend. Keep your hips square, tone your belly, open. Inhale, re-extend, and then remember, airplane or chair plane arms, so swing your arms back. Lead with your heart, hinge at your hips, come about halfway down. So you're pretty much parallel to the ground, but you still got that baby cobra in your chest. Back muscles squeeze around your spine. Think of moving your left hip back and trying to press back through the top of your left thigh. Right hip moves slightly forward and down. Take one more inhale. Leading with your heart, exhale. Dive down. So think of reaching your heart past your left knee. It won't happen, but have that intention. When you've gone as far as you can go, fingertips can come to the ground or hands to blocks. With each inhale, really fill up your back body. Fill up your low back, your hips. And then as you exhale, see if you can dive a little bit deeper. So just soften around the posture. Draw your belly button in and up. Forehead towards your shin, nose towards your knee. So really using the breath in this pose to create more space on the inside. You've got a couple more rounds. Nice work, my friends. Take one last huge inhale. And with your exhale, fold even further. Dive even deeper. Empty all the way out. Crawl your fingertips forward so you can bend your front knee. Standing splits. We won't hold it very long. So take a moment. Reach your right leg high. Spread your right toes. Get that nice stretch in your legs. Big, huge inhale, reach, reach, reach. Exhale, right knee to your nose. So bend both knees, curl in, and think of really pressing into your left foot. Now, see if you can bring your hands up to your heart center. Stay balanced on your left foot. Press into your left foot so firmly, rise all the way up, standing staff. Right knee lifts. Arms reach, inner thighs hug in.
Stay here or extend your right leg forward. Try not to lean back. Draw low abdominals in. Hold for 5, 4, soften your face. 3, reach higher. 2, and 1, let it go. Shake it out. So this time, keep your hips really still. So think of bracing through your core and just swing your arms from side to side. Try not to let your hips move. So just your upper body. And you can swing your arms as vigorously or as gently as you want. And as you do this, you should really feel into your center. So you're bracing with those low abdominals, keeping your hips nice and still, very square. It should feel relatively good. And then let it go. Mountain pose, top of your yoga mat. Arms by your sides, palms open. Close your eyes. Feel from the inside. Feel your posture, feel your alignment, feel your feet on the ground. Shoulders soft, heart open. Big, huge inhale, hold at the top, stand a little taller, take up more space. Hold, hold, hold. Exhale, big open mouth sigh. Ujjayi breath, let's flow. Inhale, high mountain. Exhale, slow dive. So traction out your spine. Take your time as you dive down, then fold in. With your in-breath, spinal extension. Exhale, plant your hand, step back to plank. Move through your vinyasa however you would like to. So add push-ups, back bend of your choice. Maybe you take a couple breaths in your back bend. And then we'll meet in downward facing dog. Inhale, right leg to the sky. Open your right hip, bend your right knee. Great place to stay. Option to flip your dog. So right tiptoes, come down behind you. Right arm lifts and reaches forward. Lift your hips, reach your heart forward. Breathe down into your belly. One more great big huge inhalation. If you're in the back bend, exhale, come back. Three-legged dog, right leg extended high. So everybody inhale, lengthen your right leg. Exhale, pigeon pose. Right shin to the top of your mat. Set your body down gently. So you guys are all really good at setting up your pigeon. Make sure you find that connection to center first. So build the structure of the pose, the strength, plug those femur bones into the sockets. And then you can start your bow forward at any time. If there's a different variation you want to take or if there's something you want to add here, please always feel free. And as you bow forward, still imagine your right hip is pulling back and up. So even as you're bowing and relaxing into the stretch, still keep that muscle energy, that hugging towards midline, the integrity of the pose. About 5 or 6 more rounds, big spacious breath.
Last couple rounds, two or three more breaths. You can exhale out your mouth anytime. So any tension, any resistance you're holding inside, visualize it moving out with your exhales. Slowly, mindfully, let's transition back to downward facing dog. You can get there however you want to. I am going to lift my upper body, plant my hands, tuck my back toes, and just take my right leg back and up to a three-legged dog. Give it a nice little shake out. So any movement you want to take on this side, any movement that calls to you, go for it. If you want to take a vinyasa, go for it. And then eventually just down dog, walk it out. Inhale, left leg high. Exhale, open your left hip, bend your left knee, right side stays strong. Stay here in this nice hip opening stretch. Good stretch for your groin, your inner thighs. So stay here if you want, or flip it over. Wild thing, left arm reaches, heart reaches, hips lift. Make sure you can breathe here, breathe down into your belly. One more huge inhale if you're in the back bend. Beautiful, you guys. Exhale, come back. Three-legged dog, left leg extended. So everybody, big inhale, lengthen, stretch your left leg high. Exhale, softly, left shin forward, pigeon pose, set your body down. So take your time, left knee towards the outer left edge of your mat. Left hip pulls back, right hip pulls forward, femur bones plug in. And then you can start your bow. As you bow, keep pulling left hip back and up. Keep plugging your femur bone into the socket. So you don't want to dump into your joints, which is probably going to feel easier. Stay in your muscles, give them that nice stretch. And you know, if there's a variation you want to take, always welcome. Big deep breaths. Exhale out your mouth at any time, about three or four more. I'm going to leave it up to you ultimately, so no hurry at all, but when you feel pretty even on both sides with your pigeon pose, just slowly start transitioning back to one final downward facing dog. Inhale, Any movement that you want to take on this side. One last vinyasa if you want to take it. And then for a moment, just be in your down dog. Stretch. Really press the earth away. Lengthen the space under your armpits. Lift your hips higher. Maybe press your heels a little closer to the earth. Take one last breath in your down dog. And at the end of your exhale, gently set your knees down. Let's find our way onto our back. So facing in whichever direction you want to, just as long as you can hear me. Come on down to your back. And then once you're there, full body stretch. So reach your legs out long, reach your arms out long. Pull yourself in opposite directions. Lengthen, lengthen, lengthen. Big, huge inhale. Hi, Rubes. Exhale, draw just your right knee in towards your belly. And then supine spinal twist. So roll over onto your left side. Right arm reaches out to the right. Gaze up or over your right shoulder. Breathe down into your belly. Perhaps close your eyes. With each exhalation, just give more of your weight to the ground. Let yourself be held. End of your next exhale, let's roll back onto our spine. Keep your left leg extended for now. Adjust your hips so they're straight down from your shoulders. Give your right knee a big hug, a big squeeze in and up towards your right armpit. And then half happy baby with your right leg. So sole of your right foot to the sky. Grab hold of your right foot. Imagine a heavy sandbag on top of your left thigh, neutral spine. So back of your shoulders, back of your hips are rooted. If when you are in your half happy baby, your chin is tilted way up and you have a huge curve in the back of your neck, your shoulders kind of lift up away from the ground, bring your left hand behind your head like a little pillow and see if you can lengthen the back of your neck. Take one or two more breaths in your half happy baby. And the end of your second exhale, let it go. Right leg extends out next to your left leg. You can either just give your legs a gentle shake out. If you want another full body stretch, take it. And then left knee up towards your belly. Supine spinal twist. So left arm reaches out to the left, roll onto your right side. Gaze up. Or gaze over your left shoulder. And breathe. So your left hip should be stacked on top of your right hip. Adjust if you need to. So anytime a pose doesn't feel right, play with it. Get curious about it. See what little tiny adjustments will do. There's a difference between feeling discomfort in a pose and feeling like the pose just is not working for your body. So start to get more and more familiar with the difference between the two. So sometimes it's just uncomfortable because we're not flexible in that way, and that's okay. But sometimes it's not comfortable because we're probably not doing it quite right. We're not in the most efficient alignment or optimal alignment for our bodies. So
Get curious, stay curious always. Take about two more breaths in your twist. And then when you feel pretty even, and again, I'll leave it up to you, you know where to go. So back to your spine for your wind removing pose. I think that's the funniest name, so I never use it. Left knee towards your left armpit, squeeze, squeeze, squeeze. And then your half happy baby. And if you want to, right hand behind your head. So that just helps with creating a more neutral spine, more length in the back of your neck. It's for people who have really tight shoulders or tightness in your legs. So I guess there's a lot of reasons why it would be helpful. So just if it's helpful, right hand behind your head. Maybe it just feels good, that's fine. When you've taken two or three breaths in your half happy baby, transition into a full happy baby. And from your full happy baby, you can rock it out. You can straighten one leg and then the other. If there's any more poses, stretches, any more movements you want to take just to complete your practice for you, now is your time. And then as you are ready, just slowly, mindfully begin transitioning into your final Shavasana. And as you get there, I have a reading for you. It's called Meeting Crisis. It's by Jeff Foster. We live in a time of great change. Perhaps we always have done. Many people I speak to are going through big changes and upheavals in their own personal lives at the moment. Nothing makes sense to them anymore. Everything they believed has been cast into doubt. They feel lost, living a life that isn't really their own. This was also my own experience for many years. Crisis is actually healthy. It means the snake is shedding its skin. The old ways, the stagnated identities, do not fit anymore. There can be no true transformation without pain. Think of Jesus on the cross or the Buddha prior to his enlightenment. Change is inevitable, and the ever-present invitation is to turn towards the pain of change and to invite this moment in. As if it had been chosen, even if you can't believe for a moment that it was. So, as humans, I do think that one of the hardest things for us to hold space for is change. It's uncomfortable, it's painful, it's confusing. That's okay. Let it be all of those things. Let yourself feel all of those things and sit with all of those things whenever they come up. And just embrace fully the transformation that you and really, I feel like this entire world right now is going through. It's not easy, but growth is never easy. Settle into this moment as you are, where you are. And just trust that you are exactly where you need to be. Soften into that. Melt into that. So breath completely effortless. Body as relaxed as possible. So just let your muscles soften. Let your body melt. And I will leave you here for as long as you'd like to stay. So if you have 30 seconds, take 30 seconds. If you have 20 minutes, take 20 minutes. Just rest, just be, and soak it all in. Thank you guys so much. I love you. Have a wonderful rest of your day. Namaste.